Hello, guys, and welcome back to Liftoff. Elon Musk, SpaceX, has built the Crew Dragon primarily to carry astronauts to the International Space Station. It was developed as part of NASA's plan to hand over space station flights to American companies after years of relying on Russian launches. Elon Musk says human flight had always been the fundamental goal for his pioneering company, SpaceX. The entrepreneur achieved that ambition on Saturday, the 30th of May, 2020, when the Crew Dragon spacecraft carried NASA astronauts Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken into orbit for a rendezvous with the space station, or ISS. It was the first crewed vehicle to fly from U.S. soil since the retirement of the shuttle in 2011. When the shuttle program ended, NASA had no immediate replacement vehicle. This left the space agency reliant on Russia to fly American astronauts to the ISS. In the meantime, however, SpaceX and Boeing worked on developing vehicles to take over that job. Crew Dragon's now making routine visits to the orbiting outpost and, as of September 2021, is also being used for fully private missions that carry amateur astronauts to orbit. Musk's vehicle evolved from an earlier spacecraft called Dragon 1, which has launched 20 times on missions to deliver cargo to the ISS. In May 2014, Musk unveiled the 7-seat Crew Dragon concept during an event at SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California. It's a capsule design, like the Apollo command modules that carried astronauts to the moon. From launch up until shortly before re-entry, the capsule is attached to a section called the trunk, which has solar panels, heat removal radiators, space for cargo, and fins to provide stability during emergency aborts. Together, the capsule and truck stand around 8.1 meters, that's 26.7 feet tall, with a diameter of 4 meters, that's 13 feet. The Crew Dragon is equipped with 16 Draco thrusters that maneuver the vehicle in orbit. Each Draco is capable of producing 90 pounds of force in the vacuum of space. If anything goes wrong during liftoff, the capsule has a launch escape system, LES, consisting of 8 Super Draco engines that each produce 16,000 pounds of force. The LES quickly separates Crew Dragon from its rocket. SpaceX engineer John Fetterspell said the company had wanted to make Crew Dragon feel like a 21st century spaceship. He explains, probably one of the biggest features of Dragon are the touchscreens on the inside. We designed them not just to be very functional, but with the user experience in mind. The 3 large touchscreen displays that allow the commander and pilot to monitor and control the spacecraft are a world away from the analog buttons and dials in the cockpits of previous vehicles, such as the space shuttle. As the first humans assigned to fly on Crew Dragon, Hurley and Behnken worked closely with SpaceX to get the capsule ready for its historic launch in May 2020. The crew members, who had previously both flown on the shuttle, provided vital input. Crew Dragon has 3 different seat sizes, with foam that's molded around the astronaut's body to make the journey to and from space as comfortable as possible. When the astronaut gets ready to strap in, they plug an umbilical line from their seat into a port on the right thigh of their spacesuit. The umbilical provides the suit with life support systems, including air and electrical connections. The Crew Dragon lifts off from Florida's Kennedy Space Center on a version of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket that's been adapted for astronauts. When astronauts are ready to return home from the space station, Crew Dragon first unlocks and then performs a deorbit burn with its thrusters. The vehicle's heat shield, located at its base, must survive the temperatures hotter than the surface of the sun as the craft screams through the atmosphere at up to 25 times the speed of sound. Then after the fiery re-entry phase, the spacecraft needs to deploy 4 parachutes to slow its descent. Finally, the Crew Dragon splashes down in the Atlantic Ocean, 450 kilometers off the coast of Florida, while recovery ships will take the astronauts to safety and retrieve the capsule. Reuters reports that SpaceX has begun to shut down Crew Dragon capsule production after assembling a fleet of 4 reusable spacecraft, highlighting the company's ever-growing desire to pivot to Starship. According to SpaceX President and Chief Operating Officer, COO, Gwynne Shotwell, who spoke with Reuters reporter Joey Roulette, the company has already ended production of new Crew Dragon capsules after recently completing a 4th operational spacecraft. Nicknamed Freedom by its crew, Dragon Capsule C212, Dragon 2 Capsule number 12, is scheduled to debut as early as April 19th and will ultimately ferry SpaceX's 4th crew of government astronauts to and from the International Space Station. However, while ending the production of Crew Dragon might sound like a dramatic and unexpected move after less than 2 years of operational astronaut launches and undeniably hints at the company's desire for Starship to take over, it's not quite as jarring as it seems. Above all else, Shotwell didn't explicitly mention Cargo Dragon 2 production. It's possible that there was a miscommunication during the brief Q&A, and that a generic statement about ending production of all Dragon capsules was projected onto just SpaceX's Crew Dragon variants, but the Reuters article strongly implies that only Crew Dragon production has been avoided. As of today, SpaceX only has two operational Cargo Dragon 2 capsules in its uncrewed fleet, both of which have already flown twice. Following a recent contract extension, SpaceX is scheduled to complete at least 11 more ISS cargo deliveries and recoveries by 2027, and while it's possible that the company is confident enough to gamble that two Dragon 2 capsules can complete all 15 CRS-2 resupply missions, a SpaceX engineer confirmed that at least one more Cargo Dragon is scheduled to debut in 2022. With three Dragons, that would at least give SpaceX the ability to confidently fulfill its CRS-2 obligations, even if one capsule is damaged or lost. Meanwhile, Shotwell indicated that SpaceX would preserve the ability to restart Dragon production if the need arose. It's easier said than done. At the same time, the company will still need to churn out at least half a dozen or so expendable Dragon trunks per year and continue building a wide range of replacement parts. A substantial team will also be needed to refurbish and operate Crew and Cargo Dragons for as long as launches continue. But by and large, the move to end Crew Dragon capsule production says one thing above all else, that SpaceX is chomping at the bit to redirect large portions of its Falcon and Dragon workforce to Starship development. If SpaceX can make it work, Starship, a fully reusable two-stage rocket, could end up costing roughly as much as Dragon and Falcon per launch, but its launch costs could also plummet to a magnitude less, all while offering a magnitude more space, performance, and capabilities. Crew Dragons currently used to launch 4 astronauts at a time. A single crewed Starship could have a habitable volume greater than the entire International Space Station and carry 40 astronauts into orbit inside it in a single launch. Cargo Dragon typically delivers about 3 tons, that's less than 6,600 pounds of cargo to the ISS. A cargo Starship could deliver tons, dozens of tons in one go. More cargo space than NASA would know what to do with after decades sent under the tyranny of razor-thin mass margins. NASA is likely the single largest individual investor in Starship after contracting with SpaceX to build a version of Starship capable of returning astronauts to the moon for about $3 billion, meaning that the space agency will intimately be aware of and involved in the vehicle's development over the next 5 to 10 years. It'd only be logical to extract as much value as possible out of that investment and simultaneously revolutionize the transportation of cargo and one day astronauts to Earth orbit and beyond. Unfortunately, there's no real guarantee that NASA will actually do that, but SpaceX's choice to end Dragon capsule production so early makes it clear that the company is more than willing to prepare the groundwork for such a transition itself. Thanks for watching until the end. Subscribe and turn on notifications to see more videos like this one, and we'll catch you in the next one. Take care.